Fatigue, brain fog, unexplained weight gain, joint pain, and muscle weakness are a few symptoms that could be attributed to an underlying issue. Parkview Integrative Medicine physician Dr. Angela LaSalle shares the warning signs, symptoms, and treatment options for one possible culprit, Hashimoto's disease.
Hashimoto's is actually an autoimmune condition of the thyroid, and this is where our immune system is actually misidentifying the thyroid as a foreign invader in the body. So all autoimmune diseases are little glitches in the immune system where our tissues are getting mistaken for things like bacteria or viruses. So the autoimmune disease is defined by what kind of antibody and what type of tissue is getting attacked. So Dr. Hashimoto was the clinician who identified this particular antibody, the TPO antibody or the thyroid peroxidase antibody, as being a part of this condition that could cause abnormalities in the thyroid levels. And interestingly, with Hashimoto's, sometimes the levels can go up, and the patient can have some hyperthyroid symptoms initially. Usually, ultimately, the client will wind up having hypothyroid or low thyroid function over time as more destruction happens on the thyroid gland.
Hashimoto's disease, or Hashimoto's thyroiditis, affects more women than men. While it can occur in teens and young adults, it most often appears between ages 30 and 60 with a strong hereditary connection. Dr. LaSalle explains why women are more susceptible or predisposed to autoimmune diseases.
That can be because of many different reasons. Perhaps our monthly hormonal fluctuations and the downregulation of the immune system that we have happen when we have children during pregnancy might make us a little bit more vulnerable to developing an autoimmune issue.
It is not uncommon for the signs or symptoms of Hashimoto's disease to go unnoticed at first. The disease typically progresses slowly, occurring over time and causing chronic thyroid damage, which can lead to low thyroid hormone levels and an underactive thyroid gland, or hypothyroidism.
It can vary. So since Hashimoto's can have kind of a hyperthyroid stage, it might be things like fast resting heart rate, palpitations, feeling jittery, sleepless, changes in your stool patterns. On the flip side, if somebody is presenting with hypothyroidism due to Hashimoto's, it can be things like fatigue and constipation, dry skin, changes in our hair and nails. Fatigue is a very common symptom that happens with changes in thyroid levels. Also brain fog, difficulty pulling for words, but it's usually just feeling off in how you're feeling. Every cell in your body has receptors for thyroid hormone, and so that's why the symptoms can be quite varied with thyroid conditions.
Because Hashimoto's disease often results in hypothyroidism, it can have a profound effect on your everyday life.
It can be sometimes difficult for people to, function with the same level of energy that they normally have, and that can be quite disruptive. But with good care and good management of the thyroid levels and replacing the thyroid hormones as needed or treating any episodes of hyperthyroidism, people can do quite well with Hashimoto's.
A diagnosis of Hashimoto's disease is based on several factors, including symptoms and blood tests that measure the level of thyroid hormone and thyroid-stimulating hormone being produced by your pituitary gland.
Taking a comprehensive history is important, getting those symptoms and making the connections that things might be related to changes in thyroid levels. But the way we diagnose a thyroid condition is through blood tests. So we'll check a TSH level along with some other thyroid hormone levels.
While there is no cure for Hashimoto's disease, replacing hormones with medication could help regulate hormone levels and aid in the restoration of a normal metabolism. Dr. LaSalle discusses additional options regarding treatment.
First and foremost is to replace the patient to the correct level of thyroid hormones in the system. If they have thyroid nodules, we may watch those thyroid nodules with serial ultrasounds to make sure that there are no concerning changes that might suggest thyroid cancer or some other issue going on with the thyroid. An ultrasound may or may not be a part depending on their physical exam with the Hashimoto's. It's very important to take a look at their nutrition. There have been some associations with gluten intolerance and celiac disease, type 1 diabetes, rheumatoid arthritis, and other autoimmune conditions with Hashimoto's.
If you are experiencing irregular symptoms or issues outside of your normal habits, Dr. LaSalle suggests evaluating your overall health and consulting your primary care physician.
So if you're having changes in your bowel habits, having changes in your energy levels, sleep schedules, first and foremost, take a look at what's going on in your universe. If you've been stressed, if you're lacking sleep, sometimes those things can be a reason for fatigue. If you're having palpitations, fast resting heart rate, those are definitely symptoms that you want to check with your primary care physician. But if all your self-care measures are in place and you're having these symptoms and they're ongoing, it's certainly appropriate to check with your primary care physician and get some screening tests to see if there's something more concerning going on. Checking the thyroid levels certainly would be a part of that evaluation.
This has been Making the Rounds, brought to you by Parkview Health.